As-salatu was-salamu ala rasulil anbiya, khatimil anbiya, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tasliman kaseeran kaseeran. Amma ba'du faqad qala Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala fi kalamil majid, inna haza al-Qur'ana yahdi lillati hi aqwam. Wa qala rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-Qur'anu hujjatan laka aw alaka. Wa qala, inna bi haza al-kitabi yarfa'u أَقْوَامًا وَيَزَعُ بِهِ آخَرِينَ. So my respected brothers and sisters, this your love not for me, this love for Quran, for our holy book and for our whole, the last revelation. And the revelation which about Allah is telling that if I send this revelation to the mountains, they can shake and with the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it's a life miracle of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After the Prophet, even he has left it for us. We don't have no Prophet. We don't have, we cannot see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But he had left it, this book, for us, for the guidance, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying. Inna haza al-Qur'an yahdi latihi aqwam. Quran gives you guidance. So we don't have the value of Quran because we have not spent anything for this Quran. We have got a polished Quran and the combined and piled Quran among us. And we have not spent on these things. Sahaba kiram rizwanullahi alayhim ajma'in. Just one Sahabi, when he was a child, and he lives in a Medina, how he collected the Quran? He said that, I am far from the Medina and daily I cannot go to the Medina, it's too far and I was a child. So I daily come out on the road and waiting for the caravans that are coming from the Medina. And I am waiting, and when they are coming from, like, when I meet and then stop these caravans and say, someone knows one ayat or two ayat? They are saying, yes, we know. So I said, he said, okay, just teach me, just teach me. So just like each and every day he is waiting and stopping for the caravans who came, or maybe one ayat, two ayat he is taking and learning. After then he got a big portion of Quran in his heart. Hazrat Umar radiallahu anhu, as you know about the Hazrat Umar radiallahu anhu sister, he is a sister and his her husband. He was teaching Quran hiddenly because it is not allowed. And if somebody sees them, then he will beat them. So Hazrat Umar radiallahu anhu, he is hiding from Hazrat Umar radiallahu anhu also. So when Hazrat Umar radiallahu anhu intended to go and na'uzubillah to kill Hazrat sallallahu alaihi wasallam, someone says to him, go and see your sister in your house, there is a fitna. So he got anger, he was an anger man, and he got anger and went to his sister's house, and he beaten too much to his sister and sister. At last, His sister was the sister of Hazrat Umar also. She is not an ordinary woman. Say, okay, what do you want to do? You can do. We will not leave this. Okay, Hazrat Umar says, okay, just tell me, what are you reading after beating him? So Hazrat Umar's sister recite, Taha ma anzalna alayka al-Qur'an. Just he recites, he turned, his heart has been turned automatically and embracing. So that is the sacrifice done by Sahaba to get the Quran. In now, early days, I have some colleagues which are studying with us from one country. I will not let you know about the name of the country. But there is one country, he was a colleague with me, and he said that my father and we are running pub, and internally we are teaching the Quran Sharif. No one knows because it is not allowed by the government. So we are running the pub and putting the board that there is a wine I've been selling on, and some wine, we are selling some wine also there, but inside, internally, we are learning Quran so that our generation cannot lose the Quran. So this is the Quran. And Quran, what is the rewards of the Quran? When someone recites the Quran, one harf, Hazur Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that he will get ten hasana. And Hazur Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, La aqulu alif lam mim harfun, walakin alifun harfun, walamun harfun, wamimun harfun. That alif lam mim is not one harf, not one word. Alif is one word. And some scholars are saying, alif is not one word, alif, lam, fa, if there are three words. So you can multiply these, we cannot imagine. But we don't have the value of these things because we have the value of the dunya. We have spent all these things and we have done sacrifice from, we have left it for our parents and all these things for the dunya. So that we have got a value of dollars. If there is an ilan, announcement here, that if somebody recite one ayat, so he will get $1 or $10 for one harf. So I think that masjid will not be empty for the whole day. All the Muslims will come and they will get. But this is the currency. This is the currency I am telling you about. Currency of amal. You know, when you go to the other country, suppose I came from the Pakistan and I have 1 lakh rupees in my pocket. So when I come to airport and I want to come to masjid, I said to say taxi driver, just drop me to the masjid. I will give you 50,000 Pakistani rupees. He will not drop me. He will tell me, okay, give me $5 or $10, I will drop you. But I need this currency. So just like this, in the akhirat, we don't have any type of currency. This is the currency of amal. اعلموا أنما الحياة الدنيا لعب ولهو. We remember this dunya which we are struggling on these all things. This is just like the playing. You know, in our childhood, I with my brother playing some cards or some toys, and my brother broken my toy. So I cried a lot, oh, he has broken my toy, he has broken my wooden car. And now when I'm realizing that these things, now I'm laughing on this, but why I am crying on these things? These are not the things. Just like when we go to the akhirat, we will see and we will laugh on our way, but we are struggling. On our wealth, on our properties, on our businesses, we will love that. Oh, this is not the actual. This is la'ibun wala. This is just a playing. So at last, I will not take a long time for you. So at last, I will request you that don't spoil your children and make them learn by Quran, because you know. The sin is not their sins. The sin is the sin of parents. فَأَبَوَاهُ يُحَبِّدَانِهِ وَيُنَسْجِسَانِهِ 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 حضور صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم said, كُلُّ مَوْلُودٍ يُولَدُ عَلَى الْفِطْرَةِ. Every children, even he's Jews, even he's a Christian or Muslim, he born on fitrat. His parents changed him. So we can say we are struggling on the dunya, our children have learned the Quran or not. And make intention to make them hafiz, and with their heart there is a Quran Sharif. Because Hazur Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, if somebody, because you see, they are giving me certificate, I'm happy internally. And when the day of the judgment, all the mankind of the million or trillion of them, so many from the day before and the akhirat, all the mankind are there. So Rasulullah said that the Hafiz's parents was worn a crown, and this crown is lightened more than the light of the sun. And say to will be said to the Hafiz Quran, Iqra wartaqi warattil kama kunta turattil. Jannat had so many darajas. Like just we are traveling on a plane, there is economy class, there is a business class, there is a first class, and there are so many classes. And the comfortability depends on the class. So the Jannat has also so many classes. So the so this will be said to the Hafiz that you read Quran and you just climb to the darajat of the Jannat Varatil and read slowly so that you can climb more darajat kama kunta turattil fi dunya as you are reciting in dunya. فَإِنَّ مَنْزِلَتَكَ عِنْدَ آخِرِ آيَةٍ تَقْرَأُهَا. Your manzil, your stop, your manzil is the place where you say مِنَ الْجِنَّةِ وَالنَّاسِ, there is the place of you in Jannat. So I am requesting you people that you have got a lot of place here, mashallah, and you have got this masjid. I am saying that this masjid has got a lot of barakah. When I go to the some cities, when I come here and see these green domes, I just feel a satisfaction in my heart. You are also feeling, because in this masjid there is much, I don't know what's the ikhlas behind, so many people are doing with ikhlas so many things. So there is a lot of place, so I would request to the management also and the station and you people also to make some madrasa and arrangement for hifz also, for alim also, and for maktab also, so that each and everyone, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cannot ask us that why you left my Quran, why you don't teach your children. Even now us, if I listen the Quran from you people, I think 90% cannot recite the Quran properly. This is not a cruelty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. One miracle, life miracle is with us, and we are not able to recite our Quran. So you have to teach yourself also, and children also, and you have to make intention for make them happy. There are so many sacrifices for this, because without sacrifices you cannot get even a dollar. And with these sacrifices, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you in dunya a lot of barakah and akhirat. And the second thing, I saw some weaknesses, because it is my first to describe the weaknesses of also here. So I saw that I went to so many countries, but I saw here in Newzealand, the people are not fond of reading Quran Sharif as much as in the other countries. It's my view, because I'm seeing here, nobody is, few people are reciting Quran. So if you understand the Quran, if you learn the Quran meaning and tafsir, interpretation, it is much better. But without knowing the meaning, if you read the Quran, you will get hasanat, and this will affect on your life also. So just make intention, and sisters also make intention. So there is a one house where it begins from the tilawat Quran. Just make intention. There are three family members or four family members, husband, wife, two children. We will start our day from one ruku or two ruku. Each and everyone will start the ruku, and then we start the day. Then you see the barakat of this house and the house which are not doing the tilawat. There is a lot of difference between barakat al-Rahman. In our houses, we are starting from the devils. They will sing, that's why there is not a barakat, that's why there is a quarreling, there is a disputes, there is a not barakat, everything is not there. Then we are complaining that make dua cannot do things if we are not doing properly. And so make intention to make these things inshallah. And sisters also, if sisters can say their son that if you read one ruku, then I will give you the breakfast, he will read inshallah. And all the ajar, now I read the Quran. My father is, alhamdulillah, alive. He got each and every harf ajar because he made me hafiz. He made me hafiz. And if I am on the right, wrong track, so he will also get the sin, just like is he getting the ajar. So aulad is the sadaqah, best sadaqah ajar. So are you making intention, inshallah, to make here all the sin? After Ramadan, you will contact their decision. And at last, Allah Yashkurin Nas, Lam Yashkurin Allah. Hazur Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam saying that who don't do the shukr of the people, he is not doing the shukr of the Allah SWT. I would like to thank to all of you people, all of this masjid especially, and the rest of the masjid, I went there also. So people love, mashallah, too much, and I just said you, they are not loving me. There is no nothing in me. They are loving for the Quran. They are loving for the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so many of them, the person, hiddenly they are doing the khidmat. No one knows. And they are doing the khidmat actually Quran. So just like Brother Abdul Aziz, he fed us daily and a lot of things and nobody knows. And mashallah, somebody is, Afraz bhai is there, he is mashallah washing my clothes and his wife is pressing my clothes. And so many khidmat, I cannot tell anyone so many of the names. And Tahir bhai also done so much, and so many of the men, I cannot tell each one name. It's for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I am saying thanks to Jazakallahu khairan, and may Allah gives all you have done in the barakat in this dunya and the akhirat, and may Allah gives you barakat in the maal, in the amal, in the your family, and in all your things. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all these, and I hope that inshallah we will be next year inshallah here to the Taraweeh inshallah among you, and it depends on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what he decide. Inshallah I am ready, and I have received a lot of love here, and I don't have any type of discomfort or anything else, and nobody is saying we just pray like this, to read like this, to pray fully free. So that's a great honor for me. So inshallah I'm not sure but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what he wants to, it is the final. So we wait for your request also, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all these deeds, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us just like in this dunya in the Jannah for the love of Quran. Allahumma ameen. Jazakallahu khairan.